Good morning, you guys. So, I had a dream about a part of a verse in 2 Thessalonians 2. And it just fits all into what I have been shown the past few days, you guys. And I'm just going to read the verse. You guys can take it to the Lord. I was laughing at first. Because last night I heard it. It must have been like 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. And I must have been awakened. And then I went into some other dreams that I really don't even remember all the pieces to it. It's not that important unless I get some revelations of, or if I can totally remember the dream. So I remember this part. You guys, I went to sleep. I was reading Daniel 11. King of the South, King of the North, and the Antichrist. Also, I was in Matthew because I don't want to go too far down the rabbit hole. I want to keep my eyes on Jesus. So I was back and forth. And also, last night, I responded to an email, trying to write back. I responded to a message, and part of the message, this person, Pitt, is in this book of Revelations. I received the first part in the dream. He spoke of the second part in the message. And I didn't go back to read the message this morning because I don't want to taint this video message. Anyway. It's an answer that we about to go home. 2 Thessalonians 2. I want to read it from the beginning, you guys. Generally speaking, not generally speaking, overall, Paul was trying to let them know that the Jesus Christ had not been returned. He was giving them the conditions in which his return would be in the day of the Lord. But he also, for what many of us believe is the rapture, is spoken about in here in this book also. This is 2 Thessalonians 2. You would have to read 1 Thessalonians 1. 2 Thessalonians, 2nd, you would have to read 1 Thessalonians before you read 2 Thessalonians. 2 Thessalonians was just a reassurance. He's just pretty much reiterating what he said in 1 Thessalonians. I will start at 2 Thessalonians 2, verse 1. You guys, this is the second time I got 2 Thessalonians, if you remember. But this one, I got a specific verse. Verse 1, now we beseech you, brethren, by the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and by our gathering together unto him, that you be not soon shaken in mind, or be troubled, neither by spirit, nor by word, nor by the letter as from us, as the day of Christ is at hand. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God, or that is worshipped, so that he is as God, sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. Remember ye not that when I was yet with you, I told you these things? And now we know that with now we know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work. And this is the part that I got in my dream. Only he who now letteth will let. That's the specific part that I got from my dream. Let me continue reading. Until he be taken out of the way, and then shall that wicked one be revealed. There's a comma there, but I do not want to finish reading it. Well, I should. Go ahead. Whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. That is talking about after the 7-year tribulation, that part after the comma. Read it for yourself. I feel like the grace period has ended, like another sister just said. She got a specific date. And also, if you're pre-trib, we out of here. And also, before I went to sleep, I was going to save it for today. I'm going to look at the video of Jonathan Kahn and the connection with Hanukkah to, I don't want to say the Antichrist, but yeah, foreshadows the Antichrist and the end times. I didn't even begin to listen to it because I was doing so much last night. All right, you guys, I will leave it up to your interpretation. I really do believe that our time is right at the door. The restrainer will not restrain anymore. And we about to be out of here. Take it to the Lord. Use your own discernment, please. Don't take my word for it. But this has been a consistent theme with me ever since Sunday when I had the open vision with the rainbow and the black cross. A consistent theme of good versus evil, the saints versus the Antichrist, so on and so forth, however you want to put it, okay? God bless y'all.